Hey guys, welcome to Last Humans Garage. Today we are going to review a Philips dash cam. And this dash cam is provided by GearBest.com. Now I'll start out by saying there will be a link right down here for the cam if you want to check it out. Now this is an import company, but they do have mainstream brands such as Philips. So they got so many things. I want to actually get some toys for my kids eventually. But let's go ahead and take a look at this Philips cam that was provided to me. I guess it's time to get that dash cam going, right guys? There's a lot of interesting drivers here out here in Virginia. Very interesting. So I need a dash camera really on front to protect myself. Let me do a crotch shot. Boom! Oh, it doesn't even work. Okay, we'll go from this side. Let's see what we got. Now, first, Philips is a brand I trust. I mean, I've had Philips TVs, I mean, in the past and things like that. In other words, this isn't a no-name brand. This is a legitimate brand. Hold on a sec. All right, a stable camera mount is always the way to go. Put out this baby, haven't looked at it yet. Let's see what else is in the box. Not a lot. This isn't a complicated system, which is one reason I liked it. I have already looked at a review of this from some other site and channel, so to give me some idea what to expect. All right, so you do get an 11-foot USB cable. And yes, I can hardwire it eventually, you know, but for now, you can either go USB into your USB port or a lighter just for now until you get it figured out. And let's take a look at the camera now. This has a very big aperture. I believe it was 2.0 or something. It was a good size aperture. Yeah, a 2.0 fixed aperture lens, very big, 3 megapixel, 1080p, full HD. This looks awesome. I like its small size. It actually looked a little bigger in the pictures, so I'm pleasantly surprised that it is even smaller than I suspected. So I'm going to take the mount and put it in the hole. Slider right in. Boom. Okay, perfect. It goes right in the middle like it should. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick it and mount it for now. You know, I can change things later if I want. I can adjust positions, but just to kind of set this up. And you have both a tight left-right. If you need to manually turn it, if something's going on, you can twist it. And it's not loose. It's not going to turn by itself. And then you have your adjustment here to get a really good angle on that camera, just how you want it. On the side, you have your USB, which is your main power source, and a reset button. You have microphones and speakers, a power button, and an SD card slot. Now that's all that there is for this. See how simple it is? And this will support a maximum of a 32 gigabyte SD card slot. So I'm going to go dig one out of my stash. I might have a 16 or a 32, I'm not sure, because I probably won't be able to get this to work until I have an SD card in it. Sweet, I went around my stash of SD junk, and I did manage to find a 32 here, an Ultra, SanDisk Ultra. Whoa, there it is, it's pretty tiny. So I'm going to insert this first, because chances are it won't really work right if I don't. I think it'll go like this. It probably does not fit. Yeah, that doesn't make sense. Crooked, yeah. So, like most SD cards, the label is kind of going to face front. I'll see if I can get it to click in. Very easy. Awesome. I love it when things work like they're supposed to. All right. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go sit in the car. I'm not going to stick it yet, and we're going to plug it in. We're going to look through all those options, which I am familiar with. All right, now I'm not sure if the USB I have is always live or not. So let's see if this will power on. So there's the power button. Oh, there we go. There we go. Now, you notice the first funny thing. It is in Chinese. So we can fix that. What we'll have to do is find the English menu, which will be a speech bubble. Let me find it here. Right here, speech bubble. Okay, go up to English. Boom, we're in English mode. Woo! All right, so let's just go down some of these. Language we did, time, date, we can change. Frequency, I'll just leave that default. You can probably turn off the loud beep too. Screensaver, fatigue driving, I'm gonna turn off. This is like if it's been running for a while, it's going to just beep every once in a while to make sure you're not falling asleep. Default is off, so that's fine. Format the SD card. I have to do this before I can use it. So let's go ahead and format that SD card. Done. Default settings is probably the last bit. System info, we'll look at that. Why not? Let's see what's up. So that looks like some kind of code there. Maybe a camera code. I'm not sure. So now we get to the top of the menu again. Video resolution. Let's take a look. I want 1080p right now. I can lower it later if it's filling up the drive too much. But what this does is, this does loop recordings for 1, 3, or 5 minute loops, right? And we haven't even got to that section yet. Probably video length. Right there, exactly. So these are loops that will go in. You adjust your time frames. And if anything ever happens, you have, while it's recording, you have your lock button right here to immediately press it. And it'll prevent that data from ever being overwritten. So I would assume that you're never going to fill up your drive because it will reach the end and start looping in the front again. I do have to confirm this. Don't keep my word for it, but I'm going to find out. So I'm going to keep it with the default 3 minute videos is what it's going to be. Then exposure, I'm not going to mess with because I am not a camera guru. I'm going to leave it 00 straight up, whatever. Motion detection, very cool, very cool. Now I'm going to have this on, in fact. If your car gets a bump while it's parked even, this will turn on the camera for a short period of time. I think it was a 2 minute clip after the bump, of course, not before. So you can't do much about certain things. But that's cool that it has a built-in motion detector on it. Audio recording, yeah, we usually don't do auto recording. Default is on. I guess I'll do default on for now. It might take up more video, not too much, but you know, if I'm talking in the car or whatever, I don't really want that in the video. However, if you get a big crash in your car, right, you may want to hear it, you know exactly what happened. So I could see that being useful. Information stamp is your time and date on the video itself. That should stay on, right? Adjust it exactly how it is. And your G-sensor sensitivity for the shock. So it depends. We can adjust it. If it's coming on too much with like a little wind, you'd make it low. I am going to keep it in the middle right now. See that? Killer. This camera has a lot of features. I am going to turn the beep off for now. And that's it. We are back to the beginning. Parking mode is also where it will come on if it gets motion detection. Parking mode. Let me double check that one for you. Hold on. Well, parking mode is the one I'm not sure of. I will have to check on that, guys. So let's go ahead and see how we can get this going. We'll go lock, system. And I have to set a proper system time in this. That's what's going on. I have to set a time. Hold on a minute. All right, guys. So there we have the live camera on. You have your timestamp on there ticking away, and you have your various options and your record options. Now it is recording already. You can see the flashing red at the top, showing that this is making a video already because of the shock and the movement, right? Because I haven't mounted it yet. And you can see the exclamation point. You would hit the button under that to lock the clip that is currently being recorded if you had any reason to lock that thing in. And to get to the menu, you would go to the third button, which takes you back to the menu, and then back to the lock gets you back to the main recording screen. Now I will get this mounted properly, and then I will show you a couple driving clips which will be included at the end of this video. It just started raining and it's... Whoa, it just stopped. It just started raining and it's bright sunny. What a trip. Alright, I haven't straightened it out yet, but here is where I have the camera. Now, this is actually a problem I can already see because I'm covering up my light sensor on my rear view mirror. See that? So it can always be a problem figuring out your spots on these. You can't really get around it anyway, is that it has to go somewhere and it's not gonna look pretty really. It's hard to hide most of the time, but you know, it could save you in a pinch. So if you're covering that light sensor, you're not going to get your lights dimming properly at night when the headlights shine in your mirrors. That's something to think about. And just to show you kind of how I wired it, now I got to get all these fingerprints off the whole glass, of course, where I was fingerprinting everything. So I actually had to go on this side so I don't interfere with that sensor we just saw. And I'll do something like that, and you know, I'll test this a while. I don't know if it's permanent, but the thing is, any camera I get is going to have to be here. I couldn't do it higher because it's going to pick up this assembly. So this is really all you can do with these things. And I definitely didn't want it in the ideal spot down here because it would be right in the front of everything. I mean, I don't know. You guys let me know what you think about someone seeing it and breaking a car for it. Probably not. But having it just really stand out in the bottom might not be the right key. Anyway, I went up along here, up along the headliner, into the A-pillar. You can't quite see it. There's a little half inch of wire in the corner. Right down, let me get you a little bit of a light. Right down the A-pillar, under the rubber, actually, under this rubber that we're looking at. And I took out the glove box here, and it comes across under the glove box just so I could get to it. And this is where I'm at so far. I'm making my way to the console. Now, this might fit, it may not, but you know, ideally you want a hard wire for this, and I'm not exactly sure which, you know, what I'm gonna end up with or what setup I'm gonna end up with. So I'm not like gonna hardwire anything yet. I'm just kind of testing this out for a while, and you won't even see this video for a few days because I gotta make driving videos and it's raining and I have ceramic coat curing, so I'm not gonna go take it out right now. So this will be put on the back burner for a while, but this is the introduction part, and maybe we can come up with a better spot for it. I don't really see how. I don't see where else you could put it, but you know, I'm open to suggestions on that. See what we might find. I think putting it on the bottom near the dash would look weird, but you wouldn't even have a good angle either. So you can't really put it way down at the bottom too and just keep your top clean. So that's about it for now, guys. I'll get back to you when I can finish up this video and then show you all these results in this product.